This Is Your Moment is brought to you courtesy of Destiny Worship Center, Thika.
This is your moment.
The topic that we are sharing is surviving the seasons of life, but I want you to give me the current subtopic, dressing for your season. Dressing for your season is what I want us to get into in Ephesians chapter 6. Ephesians chapter 6, while you are standing, I want you to understand verses 10, 11, 12, and 13, 14, and 15 is what we have to cover today. Last Sunday we couldn't finish but the introduction, but today we will try to run fast and achieve more, because the Lord on Sunday needed to challenge each one of us to build capacity, to build capacity. The Bible says, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the full armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places. Verses 13, the Bible says, Therefore, take up the whole armor of God. And what is the reason? That you may be able to do what? Now, where the word withstand is, I want you to put the word survive. Let's read with that. Let's read with survive where withstand is. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to do what? To survive in the evil day. And having done all, to survive. Surviving the seasons of your life and dressing for your what? Now let's read. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. Father, in the name of your Son Jesus, I pray that you will use me in this 30 minutes. That I'll be able to share with this beloved brethren your word that truly will never pass away unfulfilled. Your word that will transform their lives and mine. That will transform the lives of those who will come to work with us, or who will stay with us, or who will travel with us in planes and buses and vehicles. That God will be able, because we are dressed up, we will be able to save others and equip others for survival. We bless you, Jehovah God, and we exalt you, because you will do more than I'm asking you today. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. You may take your seats in the presence of the Lord. Dressing for your season. I wanted to understand, if you are interested in watching television, the last 2 days, if you are interested in watching television, you'll realize that Kenya, Nairobi in particular, has experienced a new wave of change, including the famous Kidero grass, which actually has finally grown. And I thank God for the miracle grass, because after the President of the United States leaves, we will enjoy the green grass. Therefore, it was not planted for him, it was planted for us. But why was the governor of Nairobi doing what he was doing, souping up the city, painting buildings? Why was he planting grass that he knows cannot grow in 3 days? Why was he doing all this? It's because he was trying to prepare the city for the coming of the number one in the world, the President of the United States of America. If you look at our armed forces, or the askaris, or the if you look at our police, if you look at our, you know, the U.S. Secret Service, or the FBI, or the agents that travel with the Presidential Guard, including our own, you will discover they had gone a little bit, an extra mile in protecting themselves by putting up protective gear. So that, and then they have a little bit of some serious American rivals, hallelujah, automatic rivals, because they have to prepare for the coming of the world number one. Preparation is the first thing that you do, not the last. Preparation for anything is the first thing that you do, not the last. The grass may not have grown in 72 hours, but I tell you the truth, that grass will be green. That grass is standing green every day. The army, the Kenyan police, the Kenyan, you know, administration police officers, the regular police, I believe also the rest squad, or the GSU department that does PIP protection, and the FBI and the Secret Service of the United States, we are ready and they are dressed for the what? Come on. For the season that is in Kenya for 3 days, that is their arrival and the 3-day visit of the American president. I want you to understand, as children of God, ours is not for 3 days. We don't dress for 3 days. We don't dress for 1 week. We don't dress for 1 month. We don't dress for 1 year. We dress to survive the seasons of our lives, because every day we are ready for the challenges that come our way and for the blessings and the breakthroughs that come our way, including the breakdowns. The Bible says, let's go back to the Ephesians. You know, that's why we have to dress up. It says we have to take up the whole armor of God, that we may be able to withstand. To withstand. Hey, Kiswahili ni kusema nini ndugu yangu? Kusimama. To withstand. That we may be able to withstand. We take up the whole armor of God, that we may be able to withstand in the evil day. I want you to know this, and it's not the first time you have heard this. Bad things happen to good people. Bad things happen to good people. They happen to the righteous and the unrighteous. They happen to people that are prayerful and people that eat every day. They happen to all human beings. There are things that befall human beings that we have to dress for. We have to prepare ourselves for. And if you think I'm talking about evil things, I want you to understand, the only person that has the excuse in this world not to prepare for their coming is a baby. A baby is not given a chance to prepare for the world they are coming in. But the mother and the father spend a lot of money in preparing for the arrival of that baby. Isn't it? They prepare because the baby cannot just land. We all know of something that happened in Nyeri. A woman that went in when she was in labor, and the doctors and the nurses behaved the way they behave in our country, and they did not attend to that lady, and the baby came out and landed squarely on the what? On the floor. What made that lady leave her home to go to the hospital in Nyeri is because she knew she was not prepared enough to deliver at home. She wanted somebody else who can help her, but they were not willing to help her. The Bible says we have to take up the full armor of God, the whole armor of God, that we may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to do what? To stand. That means, having faced everything that you face in life, the challenges that you face in life, the Bible says they are supposed to leave you doing what? Standing strong. But some of the seasons we go through life don't leave you strong. They leave you weak. They weaken you. They torment you. They frustrate you. One of them are moments of fear. Moments of fear don't give you a chance. Moments of fear don't give you a chance to prepare. When fear grips you, fear does not give you a chance to apply your faith, because fear is the greatest assassin of faith. Adui mkubwa wa imani ni nini kwa Kiswahili? Ni uoga. Seasons and moments of fear. And the Bible says we are to be able, we are to dress ourselves with the armor of God, that we may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. Tell your neighbor, I'm a survivor. Yes, I am a survivor. If you are not a survivor, you don't live in this world. If you are not a survivor, you don't live in this world. You have survived battles at work. You have survived battles and sorcerers and witches and enmity. You have survived gossip and rumors. You have survived dangerous moments. Some of you have survived accidents where others died. Some of you are still working in a place where others have lost jobs that were more senior and more qualified than you. Some of you are healed from diseases that killed other people. If you listen to the world news, you know, or special whatever features on the Ebola epidemic, you will discover there are people who are called Ebola what? Survivors. They got Ebola, but by the grace of God and preparation, because they took preventive measures and they quickly acted and they did what they needed to do. The Bible says, because that's what I'm a Biblist. You know, the records say there are people that have survived what? The Ebola epidemic, because they dressed themselves up or they took the precautionary measures that they needed to take. And others died of Ebola while others survived. What is the difference between those who died of Ebola and those who survived the same disease? It's because they took measures and prepared themselves for it. The Bible says at the end of it all, we are supposed to be survivors. We are supposed to survive in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. I don't want to keep you like I kept you last Sunday. I want to make sure that I do this in 30 minutes and get out of your way. But hear me, friends. Some of us are not dressed up. Some of us are not dressed up for the seasons of life that we face. One of the seasons is called joblessness. Let me just deal with a few of them before we go to the uniform that we're supposed to wear. Joblessness. Joblessness. How many of you know that people that are qualified lose jobs? Good. How many of you can say confidently, I am prepared for job loss? Nobody. Nobody prepares for job loss. Yet, you depend on that job. I'm just picking one. Or two, you depend on that job for breakfast, lunch, and supper. You depend on that job to buy shoes, to buy clothing. You depend on that job to pay rent or pay mortgage loan. You depend on that job to pay your car payment, to make your car payments. You depend on that job to take your children, come on, to school. To school. You have taken them to the best schools that are there available. Private schools, and some are more private than others. Some private schools are more private. I'm not just talking about Joystick Academy. It's a private school, Joystick and Joyless Academy. I'm talking about some private schools that are a little bit more private than others, like Brabourne. But have you seen people, because they hit a season they never prepared for? Have you seen people move their children? Can I preach with you? Have you seen people move their children from Braban to Joystick? Have you? Have you seen people sell their car to pay the mortgage loan, and they can no longer keep it because they hit a bump and they lost their job? They were fired from their place of work, or they lost their job, or the company went down and they can no longer drive what they drove. They can no longer live in the house where they lived. Their children cannot go to the same school where they used to go, and they have to move from a bigger house to a smaller house. And occasionally you see them go to the clinics to see what? The doctors. Why? They have migraine what? Headaches. And occasionally you will see them do this. And others don't need the ones with water. They have a pile of Maalox, Acto, in their handbags and in their jackets. Then they just throw it in there. They chew it up quickly and then they put another one in. Now, all those things happen. And then sometimes you hear others being told by the doctor, you have chronic ulcers. They have become peptic. Why do people who are so ready here today, why do they find themselves in a situation where they can no longer enjoy what they enjoyed? If you want to know what I'm talking about, ask Kalem Bendile, the former MP and assistant minister of elephants. That's all he used to call it, assistant minister for elephants. When he lost the election, by the time the president rescued him, Kalembe Ndile was an image of the former Kalembe. But now, because he has been returned back to power, he is now. What happened to Kalembe Ndile after the 2013 election, when he was an assistant minister? He never prepared for the change of what? Come on. Of season. Bad things happen to good people. It is painful for you to move your children from school A to school B. It is painful for you to move from a housing estate where the chosen few live, and you find yourself going to a different environment where you don't even know how to spend the day in that environment. It is even worse when you have to lose everything and go back to your mommy and your dad and depend on them for what? Breakfast, lunch, and supper. These are what changed. What changed was not your name. What changed was not your life. I mean, what changed was not your height or your whatever. What changed is your status. Your status changed, but you did not prepare for the change of what? Come on, of the season. Are you understanding what I'm trying to say? How many of you have seen people close down businesses? Why do they close down business? Because the business is no longer profitable. It is no longer making what? Money. It is taking money out of your pocket. And therefore, it becomes impossible for you to continue with this business, because this business is no longer bringing money to you. It is taking money out of your pocket. And you close it down. I want you to understand there are seasons. that come to normal people, that come to praying people, that come to Christians who love the Lord and they are dedicated and they are yielded to God and they don't have to be good. But the Bible says there is an uniform, there is an armor, the Bible calls the armor of God, that the children of God are different from Kalembe Ndile. Tell your neighbor, I'm different. I am different than Kalembe. Kalembe depends on an election to survive. You depend on the armor of God to withstand the evil day. You have an armor. You have an armor, a uniform that you can wear, child of God, and you can stand anything. What is killing people can become your platform to success. What is destroying other people can become your platform to joy. Because you have an armor of, you are wearing the armor of God. This is what separates men from the boys and women from the girls. A child of God wears a certain uniform. The Bible calls it in Ephesians what? The armor of God. Unfortunately, a lot of people that go to church are not wearing their what? Their armor. How many of you know that it's the law in Kenya to wear an helmet if you are riding a motorbike? Everybody, how many of you have seen motor riders or motorcycle riders without an helmet? How many of you have even seen some of them who have a lot of faith carrying their wife, their only wife, and there are four children from the steering? The little one is there. The little one is holding the steering like a little monkey here. Then behind him is his elder sister, right there between the steering and the top of the higher part of the tank. And then below the tank, in the middle of the tank, is the standard four brother. And then between dad's legs and everything, there is the standard seven brother. And the wife is hanging behind him. And behind there is the other one. Is the last born. And none of them is protected for the journey they have taken. Christians take risks like motorcyclists. They walk around without the armor of God. And what happens when those people get into an accident? Our whole family is wiped out. Today, in a few minutes, I want to challenge you, brothers and sisters, my fellow brothers and sisters, and all those that are watching us on television and through YouTube and any other internet portfolio across the globe. I want to challenge you today that you check every day you wake up whether you have your uniform, whether you are dressed up for the season ahead. We live in the days of chochote, chaweza, kutokea. Thank you, my brother. I'll call you again. Give me verse 14. The Bible says, stand therefore. The word stand here means be on guard, whether you are walking, whether you are flying, whether you are sleeping, whether you are walking, whether you are in church or outside church. Stand therefore. It's a status, it's a condition of life. It says, as you walk through life, therefore, stand having guarded your what? Your waist with truth. Ay, 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 ay. Stand as you walk through life. Can I? You know I have a jacket, isn't it? Yeah, at least. So I don't have to cook because the temperatures have changed. Jipange ndada yangu. Unapoenda kazini, unapoamka asubuhi, jipange. Tumsifu, ebu simama. Did you know that the day you boarded that bus to go to Busia, you will end up in jail? Did you? Were you prepared for the jail?
No, sir.
Did you go to jail?
Yes, sir.
Why did you bind those cells in Jesus' name and cast them out to the bottomless pit? Why couldn't you say you dose? Here comes tumsifu, ambaye hata jina lake inamaanisha tumgoshe. Na hapa siingi. Kwa vile nikitoka nyumbani sikuwa naingia hapa. Nilikuwa ninaenda kuona baba yangu. Lakini hapa shetani na mapepo yako. You demons from hell. You manless demons from hell. I want to give you a piece of my Christian mind. You will not lock me up. I bind you in Jesus' name. The more you bound them, the more you were pushed in. And as they handed over this brother, I can now make fun of it and preach about it, right? And as they handed over this man back to me and Mama and Pastor Emmanuel, one of the askaris looked at him and said, "Ay, ay, 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 ay. How comes tumekana wewe siku saba na tuja kunyua nywele na ndevu?" Kaniambia, "Bishop, nipatie huyu nimfanyie kazi. Hawezi kuwa ametoka jela akiwa na nywele." You know, there are seasons that you don't prepare for. But the Bible says, so that because they change without notice, what are you supposed to do? Come on. Stand therefore. Stand and let that season find you standing. Let that season find me standing. The season may change, but my God doesn't change. The season may change, but the promises of God don't change. The word of God doesn't change. Circumstances change, but God doesn't change. So how do you get in and come out with your hair? How did they forget to cut your hair? Because as you entered in with God. And you prayed and said, "God, protect me from this dungeon. Send your angels to come with me. For I don't belong here. I am simply passing through." If you needed to go to jail so that I can use you to preach this message, then that's good. All things work together for good to those who love the Lord. You can see it. He never prepared for that season. He went through it and did not become a prisoner. He went through it and he's not in jail right now. The Bible says there is therefore now no condemnation to those that are in Christ Jesus. For the law of the spirit of life in Christ has set us free from the law of sin and death. Do not greet tumsifu at an angle of somebody who was in prison. No, he is mtu akianza kuangalia na macho ambayo yanakaa kama yako na pilipili. Mwambie nilipitia huko, lakini siko sasa huko. Ikiwa you used to be a robber, you used to steal cars, and some of the believers here know that you used to be a car robber, tell them, "Don't greet me like a car robber. I am no longer stealing cars. God delivered me from that and changed my name and gave me a new thing." The Bible says, stand. Tusome hiyo wote. Kwani umetoa wakati nataka kusoma? There is therefore. Come on, let's read. There is therefore, when? Now, no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, who do not walk according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. I'm telling your neighbor, survive this season, my brother. Survive this season.
We welcome you for a wonderful time of fellowship, worshiping, and listening to the season one of the Lord in our Sunday services, 8:30 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. We are located in Thika on Kenyatta Highway, next to Munene Industries at the Thika High School Junction. We also have lunch hours and morning glory services every weekday at our town annex church, situated at Thika Main Stage behind Magunando Supermarket. Come and let's worship the Lord of Hosts. Would you want to get your own copy of this message or any other message brought to you courtesy of Destiny Worship Center Thika? Call the number on your screen and place your order.